So this video is just going to show the updated features of my add-on, the animated render border. So if you haven't seen the first video, I'd suggest watching that first, as that'll take you through why you might need the add-on and what it does and how to use it. So this is really just going over the new features. So the first thing I'm going to do is enable the add-on. And the reason why I'm showing you this is because we have a new option. So if I just enable the add-on and expand the animated render border panel, we've now got an option here for displaying the border dimensions. And if I just enable it, you can see we have our border dimensions. So I'm going to close the user preferences, and if we just enable the animated render border, and let's choose the mesh, and we can see it has adapted to the resolution. Just a small little change, but maybe some people will find it useful. The next thing is something a bit bigger, and obviously a big problem of the first version was that when you pressed render, kind of render appeared to freeze, and although the rendering would be going on in the background, it wasn't immediately clear, and it also wasn't possible to cancel it. So that was my main focus for doing the second version, was to fix this. And so if I press render, you can see we've got a nice little counter, and while you can't navigate the 3D scene, you can see the 3D viewport update with the animation, and if I just press escape, you can see that the render has cancelled. So obviously that's a lot better than the first version. One small thing to note is that even after pressing escape, the current frame has to finish rendering before the render will stop, as I don't think there's a way for me to interrupt the render like the normal renders can be. Now, another improvement is the types of objects that can now be tracked. So originally, only mesh objects could be tracked, but I've got a few other objects here, and they can also be tracked. So the types of object we can now track are fonts, curves, surfaces, mater objects, lattices, and armature objects, as well as the mesh objects. Now, there are some limitations with some of the object types. So with a mesh, we've got the option to either use the bounding box for the tracking, or if I turn that off, it'll use the vertices. But obviously something like text doesn't really have vertices. So if I just select text, which is known as a font object, we can see that it has greyed out the option to disable the bounding box, because basically that's the only other option it can use. And that's the same for mater objects. So if I just check mater-ball, you see we can't uncheck bounding box because that's the only thing it can do. And then going back to mesh, we can again enable or disable it. So I mentioned that we could also track lattice and armature objects. Now they are also a special case, because while we can track armatures absolutely fine, and we can also, you know, turn off use bounding box and it'll use the bones to do the tracking instead, if we try and do this in a version of Blender prior to version 2.76, so even just in 2.75, this won't work. Basically in 2.76 there is a new bit of code for armatures and lattices, which means they can use the bounding box. If you're in a version of Blender that is prior to 2.76, there'll be a small warning that will come up and say basically you can only use the inner points version, you can't use the bounding box, and so this will be greyed out. Now you may have seen that when I selected the armature as the object we're going to track, we have this extra field come up, and you'll see it says bone to track, which is optional. So if we leave this blank, it will use all the bones in the armature to track it, but we can also choose one of the bones to track on its own. So you can see, if we want, we can just track one of the bones. Now one of the other bigger updates for this add-on is that we now have a new tracking mode. So previously we had object tracking and group tracking, and now we have a third mode called keyframe. So if I switch to that, we can see we have a slightly different UI. And that's because this mode isn't actually to do with tracking, as in we're not going to be tracking an object, we are going to be keyframing the border itself. So you can see here we've actually got control over each side of the border rectangle, and adjusting these values will adjust the border. Now obviously it's going to be a bit cumbersome to only be able to adjust the border via these values, so what we can do is go somewhere in our animation, press Ctrl B, which is the normal way of enabling the border, draw a box around something, and choose Insert Keyframe. We can then move to another part in the animation and redraw the box and insert a new keyframe. And if we go in between, we can see that the border is animating between the two keyframes. Now, let's say that I drew the border, but I then wanted to be able to adjust or fine-tune some of the border values. And you'll see down here it says refresh to synchronize border values. So if you don't need to manually fine-tune the border, you can just insert the keyframe straight away. But if you want to then adjust these values, we just need to refresh so that these values read in the border we've just drawn. So we click refresh, and we can now fine-tune our border before inserting a keyframe. And we can, of course, just insert individual keyframes by just pressing I over the values. And we can also delete keyframes all at once by using this delete button. Now, these values do have some limits, and the only limits are that you can't have a maximum value that is less than the minimum. So if we drag this value down, you'll see that the minimum value then adjusts, so it is always less than that value. And the same thing happens with the other values. So that's basically it for keyframe mode. If we go back to object tracking for a minute, I just want to show how the bounding boxes are now slightly better managed than they were before. So before, if you were to draw bounding box and then you switch to a different object, it would leave the bounding box visible on this old object. So you'd always have to remember to disable this before you picked a new one. But now, if we just select a different object, we can see the bounding box has disappeared from here and has appeared on here. And we can continue to change it, and the bounding box will jump to whichever object. And if I just add these two to a group with Control G and go over to group tracking, you can see we've got the bounding boxes enabled for both. If we switch back to object mode, only the font does, because that is also the object to track here. And if we go to keyframe mode, all the bounding boxes disappear. So that's basically it. That's a summary of some of the things I've done. It's a mixture of improving old features and adding new features and a few bug fixes. One other thing that I've also updated is the user guide, which has all the information on how to use this add-on. And it probably goes over in a bit more depth than I have here of all the new features and all the new options. So this was just a quick overview of the new features of the add-on. Version 2 of the animated render border is available to buy on the Blender Market.